some years ago, I was at a youth retreat where they had
one of the great questions that people
God the Creator
should be obvious by these gentlemen.
If you were looking down
Lord Jesus from
high minds of God the Creator.
The next thing on God's schedule is the resurrection of the believing dead. Who is going to be raised? Well, the dead in Christ. That term, the dead in Christ, is not uniquely a Christian term. It means the dead in the Messiah, those who have died in hopes of the Messiah. Immediately on that will be the reconstitution of the bodies of those who are living, so that we will be caught up together and there will be a double reunion with them, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Will we recognize our loved ones in heaven? If we recognize them down here, of course we'll recognize them there. In fact, the scripture points out that we'll recognize all of God's people. There will be no need for name tags in heaven. You'll recognize Moses and Abraham because, well, they'll look exactly like them. At the present time, we don't look like us, you know. You see a little wizened up old soul, maybe full of arthritis, bent over. That's not what she really looks like. We will receive the things done in the body. In other words, there will be a kind of turning inside out, and the hidden man of the heart will then be manifested. And every one of us will be given back our fully developed personalities as wrought by the Spirit of God through grace. And in that day, every one of us will be like Christ. We will be uniquely like Christ in a way that no one else will be like him. And we'll all be given a new name, a name that matches our personality. The Lord Jesus, throughout the Old Testament, he would pause, he would visit through these pre-incarnate revelations of himself. He would visit Abram and Moses and Sarah and so on, and he would change their names, wouldn't he? And he changed Peter's name. He changed others. He would give them a new name because the old name didn't really match what he thought of them. And so he would give them a new term of endearment. The scripture says, he calleth his own by name. That doesn't simply mean that he knows what your name is and use it. He has a new name for you, a new term of endearment. And every one of us will be given a new name when we get home to heaven that will exactly match us. And every one of us will be like the Lord, but uniquely like him in a way that no one else is like him. You can see this through the Old Testament. You see, when I say Abraham, you think faith. When I say Moses, meekness. When I say David, you say a man after God's heart. When I say Job, you say patience or endurance. That doesn't mean that these other men didn't have these other graces, but it seemed there was a particular grace that the Lord was working into their heart through those circumstances. And so every one of us has a custom-designed set of circumstances. Some people have physical pain, some people have financial reverses, some people have family problems. Different sets of pressures that are brought to bear on our lives, not to crush us, but to mold us and change us according to his divine plan. When the potter sits down to the wheels, he sees, when he looks at that lump of clay called you, he sees a perfect vessel. The perfect vessel is not on the wheels. The perfect vessel is in the mind of the potter. And as he presses on the clay, wonder of wonders, that misshapen lump of clay, little by little, becomes more and more like the vessel in the mind of the potter, until one day the two vessels will match. And you will be just what he had in mind. Isn't that marvelous? So that when you get to heaven, you will have a special portfolio. The grace that God has worked into you, his mercy and kindness, you will have the privilege of revealing to the world a particular aspect of the loveliness of Christ that no one else will share with him just the way you do. And you'll be able to tell how through the circumstances of life, oftentimes circumstances that you thought were quite a mistake, and you wouldn't have planned it that way, you would plan your life just the way he's planning it if you knew as much as he did. and he's working it out. And in that day, we will be the trophies. We will be the 3D audiovisual presentations of the grace and mercy of God, according to Ephesians chapter 2. He will manifest his manifold grace, his manifold wisdom, and his manifold mercies in the lives of his people. And we'll have the privilege of showing people how God reached down, took something out of the miry clay, lifted it up, took us out of the dunghill, and has set us with princes. Ladies and gentlemen, the Christian has his ups and downs, but we're guaranteed the last one's going to be up. And the hope of the child of God is all bright, it's all happy, and we look forward to that with unmingled joy when we shall see him as he is and be like him at last.